Hello, in this video we're gonna take a look at the Antec power supply. It's the model is Antec High Current Gamer 750 watt 80 plus bronze. So what's the problem with this power supply? Firstly, we're gonna test and see that it seems to be okay. So I connect the cable. I have shorted the third and fourth pin. As you can see on the pinout here, it's ground and the green one, which is power on, but all the cables are black, so you can see which one is which. You connect them, you press the power button, and we can see that the power supply is starting. We can see the fan spin. I'm gonna connect the black probe to ground. This one. This one. And we're gonna see our 3.3 is present. Our 5 volt is present. Our 12 volt is present. Minus 12 is present. So everything seems to be okay. And I thought it was okay. So a client brought his PC that he assembled himself, and the first thing I found out that was the motherboard was shorted. I didn't see exactly where, because the motherboard was under warranty, so he replaced the motherboard. I connected CPU RAM, and when I connect the power supply, and I see shorted, something smelled burnt, and the motherboard was dead again. So I had to check more carefully the power supply, and when all the cables are black, you can't really see which is one. You just check randomly to see if you have all the voltages present. So what was the problem finally after two burnt motherboards? As you can see here, I'll show you on the cable later. The 5 volt standby and the 12 volt here are inverted, so we have 12 volt here and 5 volt standby here. So when you connect it to the motherboard, you send 12 volts to the 5 volt line, and I think the USB 3 controller was shorted instantly. So let's check together. I'm gonna connect the black to ground again, and we need to test the fourth pin, fourth and third pin. So the fourth should normally be 5 volts, and it's 12 volts, and the third, that should be 12, is 5 volts. That's not good. I'm gonna close it. So I don't think that the problem was with the power supply, but with the cable, because it's a modular power supply. So if we turn this the other side, we can see that the second line goes here, the third here, and the fourth here. I'll show you the cable. So that's the cable, and if we our multimeter on the resistance mode, we can see that the second, which is 12 volts, goes here. Let me you see that it's beeping. The second one, let me double check again. The second one from here should go. So let me show you better. So the second pin goes here. So the second, which is 12 volt, goes here. The third, which also should be 12, doesn't go here. The third and goes here. And the fourth, that should be standby, goes here. So these two are 12. Or should have been 12, and this one should have been 5. So if we can see on our power supply, these two lines is the second and the fourth, and we can see that they are beeping, so they are on the same line. And the 5 volt is not beeping, so it's a different line. So I can explain it a little not very good. So I think that the problem mainly is that the third and fourth pin here, the cables should be inverted. I don't think that the client did something wrong to misplace the cables, because you cannot really remove them and plug them again. It's very hard. So I think that it is a design flaw. So somewhere in the wiring, those two cables were mixed. And as a result, the power supply sends 12 volts here instead of here, and you have a burnt motherboard. Just curious is if somebody else has the same problem with this power supply, if it's a design problem, or if I'm the only one who has this problem. I'm not gonna fix anything here, because this is also under warranty, so the client will have to replace both motherboard and power supply again and bring them back for assembly. That's it for this video. Thank you for watching.